Okay, just take note that this presentation is purely for educational purposes. It does not take into account specific investment objectives, financial situation, or particular needs of any particular person. All right, moving the disclaimer out of the way. Some of you who are new to the webinar, again, I use a lot of price action for my analysis. I've been using the same strategy for the past 5 to 6 years. And basically what I do is that I want to identify the phases that the market is in, regardless of which time frame. It can be a weekly chart or 1 minute chart or 5 minute chart or 2 hour chart. It's important to know what you're trading and what's happening. Alright, typically I'm a trend trader, which means that I try to find markets which shows really nice trends, and I just join the flow. So I mean, if you look at my screen, more often than not, you'll see at least many 20 different type of instrument of markets, from FX to commodities to indices. And the whole point is, what I'm trying to achieve is I'm trying to find the easiest market out there to trade. All right, based on technical analysis. Okay, so price action is very important to me. I'll not cover much theory in this webinar, but hopefully if you attend subsequent future live webinars, you'll get the gist of it. Okay, but I mean, across my years, I've about a decade of experience in the industry, and whenever I see successful full-time traders, I notice that price action seems to be something that they all use in terms of technical analysis. Okay, so moving on, let's go to the charts now. All right, if you look at a lot of the indices for the past 2 weeks, it's really doing absolutely nothing. So I mean, my preference is right now I'm staying slightly away from indices for this next 2 weeks, for the last 2 weeks, sorry. But I'm just waiting for some certain levels to break out so that I can start being interested again. Okay, but for right now, I mean, we all know that this is the S&P 500. So we all know that it has bounced up from a key support level, I think a couple of months back, around in the February-March period, and it made one straight up push all the way to the resistance. Okay, so based on this 2100 level, is very, very clear that it is resistance. The momentum, I mean, overall is still sideways. Recent momentum is still to the upside on the weekly chart. So I'm not surprised if we make a push to test the 2100 level again. Okay, but to me, weekly, I would say is slightly bullish to sideways because of this, the way it is consolidating for the past 6 months or so. Okay, if you look at the daily chart, alright, we begin to see a different picture. So daily chart definitely looks more bullish. Okay, what we have done is that it's consolidated since April this month. Okay, it has made a series of lower highs here, you see. Okay, which means that momentum is still to the downside. Okay, a series of lower highs. However, there's no lower low created yet, which means that the trend is still not down. Okay, because it's not difficult to see that strong support level is around the 2040 area, this line that I drew here. Okay, so we have not broken that. It's still consolidation, but it's making a series of lower highs. It's making a series of lower highs. Right. So what I'm waiting for is this scenario number one. All right, is unwinding to break the support at 2040 level first. Because if it breaks 2040, it means that the bears are in charge and I'm happy to take a shot down to the next level of support, probably around the 2000 level. Okay, I mean, it tried doing that in early May, but you can see that this, in the end, it formed a bullish pin candle. So it shows that the momentum, the support is still, there's a lot of buyers still buying up at the support level. Right now, we'll see whether we can break a 2040. Okay. On the flip side, the other thing that I'm looking at is if we can break this little high here at around the 2060 level. Okay, let me show you the 4-hour chart for that. Alright, so this level here. Alright, now if we can break this level, it's quite significant because it shows that the momentum is back to the upside. I'm going down different time frames, yeah, because the higher time frames is really nothing much to do because it's still between a big support and resistance zone. But if you want to squeeze some trades in this way, I would say it's more intraday kind of setups for a lot of the indices, not just the S&P. So you can see 4 hour, I'm looking at this resistance near 2060 area. If it breaks above it, I'm not surprised. All right, let's go back to daily. So if it breaks above that 2060 6.60 area, high chance we might make another rally, maybe back to the 2.80 or so. Okay, because this is a significant lower high. If it breaks above, then the trend is changing. Alright, you can see that if you compare this swing here to this swing, you can see that it's made a higher low. So you can see that it's consolidating into some form of a wedge, isn't it? Alright, for those of you that like your chart patterns, it's consolidating in some form of a wedge. Okay, so if it breaks out of the wedge, high chance that we might try to test the 20100 level or the big resistance again. Okay, but just be patient when you're trading such markets. Do not try to jump the gun, because there's no point. There are so many other markets to trade. There's no point trying to squeeze little trades here and there when the market has no direction. Alright, so that's the S&P for you. Very similar analysis on the Wall Street, which is the Dow Jones. So if you look at the weekly chart, same thing. Alright, for the Dow Jones, the key resistance is around the 18,000 level. Alright, if you go to the daily chart, you can see that it's doing the same thing. See, a series of lower highs, and you connect the points, something like that. Okay, and basically, you just wait for a breakout. For Dow Jones, it needs to break the 17,500 level clearly, or, okay, if it breaks above 17,600 or so, then I might be keen to trade it to the upside. But when it's consolidating, I want to be patient. Okay, patience is very important in trading. Okay, so it's just consolidating for the Dow Jones and S&P. A lot of indices are doing the same thing, really doing nothing much. Alright, but it's in such markets whereby new traders do not know what the market is trying to do, and they're trying to be the first one to jump into a trend. That's where they get burned most of the time. Alright, so just be patient. Things will play itself out. Not sure when, probably next week when there are bigger news in the horizon, but just be patient. Okay, so that's the US side of things. Let's move on to Europe. Let's start with the DAX. Again, if you guys got any questions, feel free to just shout out, yeah? So the DAX, this is a weekly chart. Same thing, look at the past 1 to 4 weeks. Absolutely doing nothing. Okay, we're very range-bound situation. Support is near 9,008. Resistance is around the 10,000 level. So you see the past 4 weeks doing absolutely nothing. But if you're trading the DAX, I want you to draw this little channel that we have on the weekly chart, just a gauge, okay? Because if you look at the weekly channel, it's very obvious that if it breaks this resistance at around 10,000, all right, high chance that we might test the top of the channel here to about 10,006 or so. However, if it breaks the support at around 9,008, then we might come back down to the next support 9,004, and subsequently maybe back to the bottom of the channel around the 8,006 level. All right, it's very simple analysis. There's nothing much to analyze. Just got to wait. Okay, so that's a weekly chart. If you look at the daily chart, painting the same picture. Okay, let me just delete this line. It's not relevant anymore. But if you look for the past 14 days or so, really, really sideways. Alright, so I wouldn't touch it or trade much unless it breaks either the 9,008 or the 10,000, around 10,060 or so. Okay, these two levels are key levels to look out for. I just take note when you're looking at support and resistance, especially on the higher term time frames like daily, weekly chart, it's not an exact price. Okay, I repeat this many times, but I just want to say again, when you're looking at support and resistance on the weekly and daily chart, it's not an exact price. Okay, it can be a slight range, like maybe 10-20 points or so. Alright, depends on how the candle formation is and how the market is reacting to that level. Okay, so again, be patient with DAX, because there's really nothing much going on there. Same thing for the CAC, funds 40. I should not touch on that. Let's move on to Asia right now. Now let's take a look at the Nikkei. Among all the indices, I'll say Nikkei right now looks the ugliest. Ugliest because I really don't know what it wants to do. Okay, so if you see what the Nikkei is doing, right? If you look at the weekly chart, I mean, you can see signs that it's forming higher low and higher low here. You can see MACD that is convergence. So in the sense that the momentum is slightly to the upside, but it's just one big fat consolidation. There is absolutely no trend here. Okay, no trend. You can see that when it broke this resistance here, okay, when it broke this resistance here and formed this nice bullish candle, all right, my mind was that, okay, a new uptrend is formed. Most probably we're going back to the top of the channel. Okay, but this big red candle is probably caused by some news. I think if I'm not wrong, it was BOJ's decision to do nothing in terms of stimulus. And this big red candle was formed. And so this is where it got messy. Okay, so I'll just be a bit patient on Nikkei. I would rather look at the key levels around the 17,000 to see what happens and let it play itself out first. Okay, looking at the daily chart. Alright, so this 17,000 around here, this whole line here. I want to see what happens around here. But you can see for the past few days, again, you can draw these two lines to see that it's trapped between the 16,003 to 16,008 area. Okay, but it's just one big fat consolidation right now. Alright, don't be surprised if this trend line gets tested against trend line support. Okay. So one trade plan is that if you go to low time frame, maybe if it breaks the short-term support of 16,004, you can try to short it back to the support levels. If it breaks the resistance of 16,008, you can try to buy it to the next level around 17,300. Okay, so when the market is consolidating and sideways, you've got to really try to make use of your chart patterns, your support and resistance, and try to, you know, plan a trade around it. It's still tradable on an intraday basis. It's not my cup of tea. It might be suitable for you by all means, but whatever it is, you need to plan your trade properly. Okay, so the last three charts I showed you, there's not much direction, but it's still tradable on an intraday basis. You just need to know what you are planning for. Yep. So this is the Nikkei 225. Let's move on to the Hang Seng. So if you look at the Hang Seng weekly chart, okay, you can see that it's a bit not the clearest of trend, because you can see that it is in a downtrend here, making series lower low low highs, and then make a higher high. So this level is where the trend started to change here. This high here, okay, it made a higher high compared to this high, and then from a higher low, and then from another higher high. Okay, let me take away some of the circles. But right now, the key thing here, this circle I drew here, is actually considered a lower low because it broke the previous low. Alright, so the first scenario that I'm looking out for is for it to bounce back to the resistance level and make a drop down. Okay, so I'm going to pay attention to this level here around the 20,200 area. Sorry, 20,400 area, somewhere here. Okay, I want to see what happens around the 20,400 area to see whether this lower low is significant. Because if this lower low is significant, right, what it might want to do is that it might want to make a lower high and then continue a downtrend, and it might come and test the previous low around 19,000 or 18,008. Okay, so pay attention around the anywhere around the 20,200, 20,400 area, somewhere here. Okay, to confirm that the weekly downtrend is intact. If you look at the daily chart is already in the downtrend. Okay, it has made a lower low. Right now it's consolidating. So the key level that I'm looking out for is anywhere around here. Okay, to see whether the downtrend will continue on the weekly chart. Alright, but it looks a bit more bearish on the Hang Seng, so just be a bit mindful of that. Alright. Hi Sunil, has my screen frozen? Nope, let me check again. Nope, not on my side, it looks good. Anybody experiencing the same thing in terms of a frozen screen? Sunil, I'm changing charts. Okay, no, thanks Raymond. Sunil, I'm changing charts at the moment. Do you see the charts moving? So I'm expanding the chart and I'm hiding the chart again. Is it okay, Sunil? You know, just try to log out and log back in. That should solve the problem. You don't see that? Yeah, I think just try to log out, log back in. Any of you have the same problem? If not, I'll just just try to log out and log in, and I'll just continue from there. Thanks, Sunil. Okay, so that's the Hang Seng. Now, any other indices that you guys want me to cover? If not, I'll move on to FX because there's really nothing on the indices to talk about. But just be a bit patient, alright? This few 1-2 weeks. Singapore. Okay, Singapore blue chip. Let's go for it. Alright, so let's look at the weekly chart. Let me take away the arrow first. Okay, now, Singapore blue chip, very interesting. You see those circles I drew? Okay, this was from a webinar 2 weeks ago. Now, the reason why I drew those circles because on a weekly chart, at first, the Singapore Blue Chip Index is forming a inverse, sort of like an inverse head and shoulder. Okay, the key support for me was around the 3.1, around the 3.10 area, 3.10 to 3.12 area. Okay, that was the key support, this line that I drew here. Okay, now what happened for the past 3 weeks is that key support broke. That key support broke. Okay, so it's something a bit like the Hang Seng, whereby the weekly might be a start of a downtrend because, I mentioned this before, but when a market wants to change its trend to the downside, the first thing that normally happens is a lower low. This is the first sign, or one of the first signs that the market wants to start falling from here. But to confirm it, it needs to form another lower high and then make another lower low. Then you can say safely that, okay, the market is forming a series of lower lows and lower highs. Therefore, it's in a downtrend. All right, so the first sign has appeared. This is a lower low to me. Now, right now, let's see what happens when it tests that key level that I'm talking about, 1.312, and see whether it can break above it or it will react to it and start falling. Because if this does this, then high chance that it might test back to the previous support at around 280. Okay, so for me, the weekly has made a significant lower low. I'm very keen to see what happens around the 310 to 312 area. Okay, now some clients ask me now, because I always analyze based on high term time frame, right? So when I say that I'm very keen to see what happens around the 310, 312 area, now what does that mean? What am I looking for? So if I'm going to base my trade plan on weekly chart and I say that, okay, weekly is showing a sign that it wants to drop. It's showing a sign that the downtrend is, it might be a start of a downtrend. When if you trace back to the resistance, okay, in my mind, I see that this might be a potential lower high scenario, okay, because based on my analysis, lower low, isn't it? Now, what I'm looking out for if when it comes to this resistance level is I want to go into lower time frame, okay, maybe on the 4-hour chart or maybe on the 2-hour chart and or 1-hour chart even, and I want to see a change or trend to the downside as well. Okay, because if the 4-hour chart, for example, is still trending upwards, then I do not want to be the first joker to try to short it down. Even though the weekly chart, I know that area is key. Okay, so this is what I mean by I want to look out for something. I mean, I want to go to lower time frame and see whether there's any reaction. Because if it goes to my resistance area, near the 312 level, and if I see the 1-hour chart starting to consolidate, forming double tops and start coming down, I'll be more than happy to join in the flow, hoping that, okay, it will come back to at least the previous support here, the short-term support, and even better still, drop to a new low. All right, so this is how I manage my risk because this is based on the H1 chart. My risk is based on a lower-term time frame chart, but my profit target essentially can be on a higher-term time frame. Okay, so this is what I mean by using different time frames. All right. You guys got any questions, please shout. Alright, so this is the Singapore Blue Chip for you. This is a weekly chart. Now, let us take a look at the daily chart. It looks very similar to Hang Seng. So, daily chart has made a new low as well. It broke this key low here. Okay, it's made a new low. Now, the key thing is how it will react. Okay, let me delete this. Okay, remember that weekly chart? Let me zoom out a bit, yeah? Okay, so if you see this is a zoom out version of the daily chart, you can see that the swings here. Okay, now there are two scenarios. Either it reacts from this swing. See this previous swing has support here. This is the 308 area. Yeah? Support, and this is a potential resistance, and it might drop from here. So either it will react from this resistance or it will make another push up to this level here. See, support, potential resistance, and then drop. Okay? Now, the question is which level it will react from? Nobody knows. Okay, I don't know as well. I can't predict the future. But what I know is I want to see what happens on the lower term time frame. Okay, so the first trade plan is this. Now, if you are unable to catch anything from this resistance, what you can do is set the alarm below this support level here. And when the alarm is triggered, means that this little short-term support, right? If you go to 4-hour chart, most probably there's a support here. If you break this support, high chance we are coming down to this next level. So that's the first trade plan. Next trade plan is we want to be more patient. Let it be traced to 312 level, around the 312 level here. And then from there, go to lower term time frame, try to wait for a reversal, and then let it trade it to the downside. Okay, but you notice that my direction for both trades is to the downside because my reference point is still towards the weekly chart. Alright, so that's a Singapore blue chip for you. Mr. Yu, is that okay? Okay, Srinivas, ASX. Okay, let me see whether I have ASX. I don't even have ASX in here. Okay, there are two indices that I don't normally touch, the UK, the FTSE, and the Australia, just because of how the charts look like. Okay, if you look at the ASX weekly charts, don't really like it because of the long shadows. I guess it's tradable, just I've not really looked into it. Okay, so the ASX now, one thing that's clear is that you can see the momentum is going to upside, is broken out of a key channel level. And what I like is that there are a lot of candle close above the support. Okay, so the weekly is definitely bullish. Okay, there's a bit of resistance at the moment. Okay, weekly bullish, good to go. Let's see, let me zoom out a bit, just delete some of the lines. Okay, so weekly is bullish. Now what I'm looking out for is whether there's enough support to make another push higher. Okay, so let me draw another support level somewhere here. Okay, based on this level. Okay, so weekly is bullish. Let's go to daily. Alright, daily is bullish as well. Now the question is, now let's see whether there's any divergence up here. Momentum is still quite bullish because you can see that the MACD, right? You can see that the MACD has made a lower low, but there's no lower low on the price. So it's like, it's a slight, because it's a flat, it's a double bottom, right? So I'll say it's a slight bullish divergence. Slight bullish divergence, okay? Now the question is, Srinivas, whether bearish divergence, it's actually a bullish, which part, where's the bearish divergence? Let's see whether, you mean the high and the lower high, is it? It's more flat to me, so it's not the strongest. You're talking about this, right? This is a double top, but this is a lower high, correct? Yeah, slight. It's a slight bearish divergence. Slight, very slight. Okay. What I prefer is a clear higher high here, but the MACD is showing lower high now. This is a very clear divergence here. Okay. But yeah, you can consider that slight bearish divergence. So it is testing this support level at the moment. Okay, sorry, that's not a very straight line. But what I intend to do is that if you are going to be counter trend trading this pair, this index, right, draw a line here. Okay. And here, and here. Now, I prefer to buy it based on the weekly bullishness, but I'm not that keen to buy it right now, okay? Because it's a slight bearish divergence, which you rightfully point out, there's a chance that it might come back to the support levels, maybe either at this 5215 area or the 5250 area before bouncing back up, okay? But don't forget the weekly chart, it is bullish. It's just that right now the resistance here is quite strong, okay, at around the 5400, that's a strong resistance. So I would think that there will be a lot of profit taking and sellers on that end. So I'll be a bit more patient and see what it does when it comes back down to at least near the 5300 here. Alright, this level here, before trying to take it up again. Okay, so the trade plan is bullish. However, I'm wanting to see what happens around this support level before buying back up again. Okay. So you want to see what happens lower term time frame. Once it comes to maybe the see 5280 level. Okay, if not, the next level support is 5200. Depends on risk to reward, alright? If your risk reward is no good, then you got to go let it go down to a better level support. So if you see this level here, right? The weekly chart seems a lot clearer. Okay, but you see these two lines I drew here? So this is a this looks like a better line to react from, isn't it? The 5230 level, and then from there push higher. Okay, so it is bullish, but be patient. Okay, let it consolidate a bit and try to plan the trade based on the low term time frames. All right, Shinivas. Okay, cool. So that's any other indices before I move on to FX. Okay, there's no other, let me take a 10-second pause and I'll start with the euro dollar.